नन्देश्वर समारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Srimahans, Mahans, Tanidar Kotari, visitors, viewers, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and two-way video conferencing, having Naina Diksha. Decoding the Maya Matrix. Listen. One of the very powerful verse by a direct disciple of Sadashiva, a yogi called Tirumular, defines, decodes this whole Maya matrix. I'll recite that verse and then give you the translation. Marattai maraittadu mamadayanai, marattil maraindadu mamadayanai. Parattai maraittadu parmudal bhoodam, parattil maraindadu parmudal bhoodam. Ponnai maraittadu ponnani bhushanam, ponnil maraindadu ponnani bhushanam. Tannai maraittadu tankaranangale, tannil maraindadu tankaranangale. I'll give you the translation. In a wooden elephant carving, if you see the intricacies of carving and perceive it as elephant, you forget it is wood. If you perceive it as a wood, you forget it's a carving. Listen carefully. When you get involved in every intricacy of what is shown in front of you by building an opinion about everything as good or bad, you are caught in the Maya matrix. Listen. The every curve, ups and downs of what is being shown, what is appearing in front of you, whatever is appearing in front of you, listen carefully. Getting involved with opinions, whether it is good or bad, keeps you engaged in Maya matrix. If you build opinion about every person, every situation, everything around your life, you will polarize the whole life. All this good for me, all this bad for me. Building more and more opinion, you have to be very clear. Building more and more opinions about the things you are seeing within the matrix keeps you engaged with the matrix and establishes matrix's authority over you. Understand? Building opinion as good or bad is what I call seeing the elephant and forgetting it is wood. Understand? In the world, it is a wood sculpture of elephant. But if you perceive that as elephant, it's my world. It may look very funny, but I should ask this question. In your iPad, when you are seeing some video clip about cobra or python or a big snake, how many of you don't even touch the iPad where the face or the head of the snake is? Raise your hand. Do you remember you are all adults? And it cannot bite you from inside the iPad? Listen, so much of opinion getting built about what is seen. Many of you have not raised the hand, I know, but you will not even dare to touch the screen, I know. Now, in LED screen, if I project a huge cobra which is moving, a video about the cobra, let me ask and let me see how many are able to touch the LED screen. Listen, it may be very simple pattern, it may look too simple, but it is not. I want you to contemplate on it. It is one of the very important revelation I wanted to share today. Opinions building opinion about everything is taught to you as knowledge. Understand? Understanding about the source material of everything is wisdom. Building opinion about everything is knowledge. Knowledge is Western, wisdom is Eastern. In the opinion-based education thought current, opinion-based lifestyle, it is all about conquering. In a way, I can't even say Eastern, Western in the modern day, because in the modern day, there is no East or West. It is all one and the same. A global city, internet, has no East or West. The largest city in the modern day is internet. At any given point, 1.5 billion people are living in it. 1.5 billion people are living in it at any given point. So in the modern day, the largest city, our largest country in the world is internet. So I cannot say eastern, western. Let me put it in a more practical way. Opinion-based education, thought current, which is constantly asking you to build opinions. Listen carefully. When you are asked to build constantly opinions, you are asked to conquer whatever is perceived by you as bad. Listen carefully. Whether you are going to conquer or lose is different. The moment you decide to engage, you are conquered. You are trapped under the matrix. Because the moment you decide to engage, you accept the reality of the matrix, which is not real. Understand? About a person, if you build an opinion, good or bad, and unfortunately, your agitated mind cannot be casual and light. Why should everything be classified constantly as good or bad? No need. Light beings walk through the gates of Kailasa. Actually, Kailasa doesn't have a gate. It's a different plane. Light beings can only even reach that space. Marathai maraithadu mamada yanai. Marathil maraindadu mamada yanai. Listen to this translation. When you see a powerful elephant forming opinion about the every intricacy carved in the wood, whether you fight with the elephant, conquer it, control it, or get controlled by it, get killed by it, The moment you believe it is elephant, you are gone. You are under the matrix. Developing more and more and more opinions, whether good or bad, about the intricacies of life, keeps you inside the matrix and the feeling this matrix is real. Please listen. The Maya matrix. How it traps you and keeps you within its boundaries. Whenever you look at the source, the moment you see the wooden sculpture of elephant, if you see what it is made of, what is the source behind, you will just see the wood. The fears and greed about the elephant will not be aggravated in you. But if you allow the fears and greed about the elephant, either owning it or afraid of it, you will continue to see elephant in that wooden piece. Seeing elephant in that wooden piece whether you are enamored by it or agitated about it, you are within the Maya matrix. You are gone. Parattai maraittadu paarmudal bhoodame. What you perceive as 11 dimensions, panchabhutas, 5 elements, paarmudal bhoodame. Earth, water, fire, air, space, ether. I should use the word ether, that is much more right word. Listen. When you experience this five and intricacies of this five, the source material is forgotten. The source is forgotten. You are caught in the Maya matrix. When you start looking at the source, this five is forgotten. I should say, this five does not put you in powerlessness as usually it does. I won't say it is forgotten. It's not that I don't see these five elements, but the five elements cannot see me. Better not. It cannot put you in powerlessness. Listen. பொன்னை மறைத்தது பொன்னணி பூஷணம், பொன்னில் மறைந்தது பொன்னணி பூஷணம். தன்னை மறைத்தது தன்கரணங்களே, தன்னில் மறைந்தது தன்கரணங்களே. When you see the intricacies and beauty and the symmetry in gold, jewel, you forget it is gold. You are lost in the artwork, enjoying the symmetry and the designs. When you remember it is gold, you forget the designs and symmetry of the jewelry. Listen carefully. More and more you go to the source, more and more you are liberated, free. More and more you go to the source, more and more you are liberated, free. More and more you go towards the opinion, more and more you are bound, trapped. Because you build a pattern of building an opinion with the details, sometimes you are afraid to get into the details. Because if you get into the details, you always form opinion and it hurts you. Listen carefully. Getting into the details, not forming opinion, is what I call micromanagement. If you get into the detail and getting burnt, that is micro oven. If you get into the detail and don't form opinion, that is micromanagement. Without forgetting the quality of the source, getting into the detail, is micromanagement. I know what I am talking is just going above the head for some people. I'll give you more examples, then you will understand. If you develop opinion about person and situation, you will never look into the source of that material or that person. Always liberation comes by getting into the source about a person or about the situation or about the object. Understand? Getting into the detail and developing opinions is Maya. Does not want to get into the details and develop any opinion is boredom. Getting into the details but not developing the opinions and going to the source is micromanagement. Listen, Maya when you look around, when you see around, when you feel around, when you perceive around, if you are constantly looking for the source, it goes on liberating you. Goes on liberating you. The more and more opinions you create, more and more you are in prison. More and more layers and layers of chain getting tied around you. Layers and layers of rope. Layers and layers of thread. No one can free you from your opinion. Even you cannot free yourself from your opinion. The only way you can free yourself from your opinions is start looking at the source. Listen, if you are tied by 200 meter rope, even you cannot break the rope. You just have to jump into the fire and allow the rope to be burnt. Before the fire touches your body, you have to roll on the ground. Looking at the source, only can burn the ropes with which you tied yourself. I have seen. One of the most powerful psychological disorder is being highly opinionated, constantly developing opinions. You can't perceive without dowholing them. You can't perceive without dowholing them. I tell you, whether good or bad, the moment you dowhole them, you accept their reality, means you are defeated. Your opinion makes Maya powerful. Whether it comes to thought current, whether it comes to emotional current, whether it comes to bliss current, whether it comes to even the so-called idea of tiredness and boredom. Listen. Now I'll try to compare with some of the ideas they try to express in the Matrix. The various biomemories you can open up will open up various planes of existence for you. Various biomemories you can open up, opens up various planes of your existence. When you open up the biomemory of your dream, you open up the dream plane for your existence, perception, experience. When you open up the dream space, you experience dream as your reality. When you open up the dream biomemory, you experience dream as your reality. When you open up waking state biomemory, you experience waking state as your reality. Poor are those who experienced only lower biomemory opening and lower levels of existence. In the dream state and waking state, you are too engrossed in the details and opinions. You never look at the source. That is why it is called lower planes. Lower planes where details become too much. Details become suffering. I have seen people who get shaken even for a small injection or even hot water. If it was little more hot and they touch unexpectedly, and the way they jump and roll, make the drama. And finally, tumble the tub and pour the hot water all over. Get burnt. That is what you do. By mistake, if you touch the hot water, the way you jump and roll, you tumble the whole bucket and pour it on you. I have seen people doing it. For the sake of small temporary mood swing, they create permanent damages into their system. Small temporary mood swing, permanent damage is done to their being. Listen carefully. The planes where your life is more based on the cognition of the source, not the opinions about the details, is what I call higher planes. There, your life is more based on the understanding about the source, not the opinions about the details. The more and more your cognition is based on the source, more and more you become evolved being. More and more you are caught in the opinions of the details. More and more you are inside the Maya matrix. Listen. In the dream state or waking state, you are more involved with opinions, good or bad, right or wrong, with opinions, all movements, all actions and reactions are failure, because whether you win or lose the game, you are under the bondage. You fight with a ghost which does not exist, with your sword. Whether you win or lose, you are a fool. Because you fought with somebody who don't exist. When you fight with a ghost who doesn't exist, with your sword, whether you win or lose, you are a fool. Because you fought with something which does not exist. Life based on the cognition of the source is what I call living enlightenment. Understand? Poor are those who live only in the lower planes of existence, never had opening towards the higher planes of existence, higher possibility of existence. Opening the doors of the higher possibility of existence and making you manifest those powers of the higher possibilities of existence is Sadashivoham 2016. Helping you to cognize more and more the source. Helping you to settle down more and more with the source. Helping you to cognize more and more with the source. helping you to settle down more and more with the source. Listen, understand. It's all about experiencing 25 different states of consciousness, higher states of consciousness instead of just three. Experiencing 11 dimensions of the universe instead of just three, length, breadth, depth. Experiencing all the aspects of Sadashiva, generation, operation, destruction, delusion and liberation, instead of just three, G.O.D., generation, operation and destruction. Actually, if you don't know delusion and liberation, even generation, operation, destruction, you will not know. There are tons of your questions will not have an answer. About why, when, what of generation, operation, destruction, and you will be foolishly believing few thousand years before on one fine morning God woke up and made all this for a few days and then he rested. All right. After all, you made God in your own mold. Understand? If you understand all the five aspects, generation, operation, destruction, delusion, and liberation, you are made as an extension of Sadashiva. As I said, Sadashiva made all of us into his sea. If you do not understand all the five aspects and are able to grasp only this generation, operation, destruction, you made God in your mold. Be careful. Are you worshipping man-made God or living as God-made man? Worshipping man-made God is so-called religions, and living as God-made man is Sanatana Hindu Dharma. For Sanatana Hindu Dharma, the ultimate is not G.O.D., generator, operator, destroyer, no. Ultimate is generator, operator, destroyer, deluder, and liberator. If you don't understand delusion, even your understanding about generation, operation, destruction is too shallow, too poor. If you don't understand delusion and liberation, you are only chatting with the God through the Facebook and you will be thinking profile picture is the real picture. Most of the time, it is not. It is not. The real picture is what is in Aadhaar card, not in profile picture. Only if you know delusion and liberation, you are seeing Sadashiva face to face. If not, it is like a relationship built through the Facebook, and when you see face to face, you will be shocked. son was telling the dad, "Dad, I have 10 fake IDs in the Facebook." Dad said, "What's the problem? You can have it." "No. The Shalini whom you invited for tonight dinner is my fake ID." When you face Sadashiva directly, be prepared to face him. If you are living with the idea of just G-O-D, without delusion and liberation, when you face him, this is what will be happening. The fake ID relationship is what? Is a relationship with the G-O-D, without understanding delusion and liberation. Fake ID relationships are okay for time pass, entertainment, not for enlightenment. Entertainment religions are different, enlightenment religions are different. If you know only G-O-D, it is a photoshopped or sharped photo. The profile picture is photoshopped or sharped photo. It's not real. Understand? Without understanding delusion and liberation, if you think you are chatting with God and relating with God, you are only relating with a fake profile ID. Fake ID and fake profile picture. It can be an entertainment, not enlightenment. When you come face to face, you will have the root shock that you missed. Of course, sometimes people prefer fake ID pleasure, fake profile picture pleasure, because that gives some kind of a time pass. Understanding various dimensions of the universe, understanding various aspects of the ultimate is needed even to run your day-to-day life. Understand? You go on living as if the understanding about the universe and life and the ultimate is not required or relevant for your everyday life. For your everyday life, you only need to understand your boss and your wife and your job and your career. No. Understanding about the universe and the ultimate and you is needed even to handle your small headache. Otherwise, you will not know the source. You will go on be perceiving lot of wrong things. Doctor asked a patient, "How is your headache?" He says, "She's fine." You will go on be
perceiving non-existent, you will go on be. Perceiving things which does not exist and pursuing the goals which does not exist. Listen. Listen. Upgrading your understanding about yourself as all the 25 states of consciousness. What psychology talks, three states of consciousness, deep sleep, dream and waking state, is a homeless man, poor man's version of the reality, 25 states of your consciousness. What the entertainment, religions talk about GOD, generator, operator, destroyer, is the poor man's version of Sadashiva, God-El, generator, operator, destroyer, deluder and liberator. Don't think, if I know God, I know 60% of the God-El. No, it doesn't work in that way. The five aspects does not mean 20%. No. If you don't know delusion and liberation, you don't know even ABCD of God. If you don't understand the delusion and liberation, you don't know even ABCD of God. Till now, you are chatting with the fake ID. Fake profile picture. You may be inviting. Listen. You can make it. You can make it. You can cognize the source material, Sadashiva, just because you are still alive. Understand? Listen carefully. Still you are alive means you are perceiving, you have decided for life. You just need to know why you decided for life. If you know why you decided what you decided, you are liberated. If you don't know why you decided what you decided, that is delusion. Not knowing why you decided what you decided is delusion. Knowing why you decided what you decided is liberation. Everyone makes the decisions for name and fame and appreciation. But no one has time to appreciate the other person. It means you are all running towards a currency which is not only available, which is not worthy. Even the organizations which gives you awards, rewards, try to maintain their credibility. Even the so-called award, reward organizations are always bothered about their credibility. Credibility of their awards and rewards. All it takes is being ferocious with yourself and just picking saffron pill. The Matrix movie, only two hands and two choices. In reality of life, there will be 20 hands and 20 choices. Always choose the right, not the pleasant. Understand? In every situation, choose the right, not the pleasant. If you are tired, if you feel about you, I am tired of being good. Now all I want is to be free. You are a fool. You don't know what is freedom. If you feel, I am tired of this so-called freedom, I am sick of this so-called freedom, I really want to be right. Understand? This is the two dimensions of Maya. What do you call, consider as freedom is not freedom. What do you consider as right, take up that, you will taste real freedom. The ability to choose is freedom. No. Ability to handle yourself is freedom. Freedom is not choices. If you believe freedom is choices, you are a middle class Indian who is believing fairness is beauty. That is why this country is madly, I can say, sickening madness about the fairness and fairness cream products. Fairness is not beauty. English is not knowledge. These are all the great matrix beliefs of middle class Indians. Currency is not wealth. Fairness is not beauty. English is not knowledge. Currency is not wealth. Multiple choices are not freedom. Always choose right, not pleasant. Choose right, not pleasant. Sometimes right may come with pleasantness, but even there, the pleasantness should not be the reason why you chose that. It should always be the right, not pleasant. You can see how your mood swings. When your body is filled with hormones, what you think as pleasant suddenly loses its power over you. A small hormonal change, it loses power over you. A cup of coffee is enough sometimes to change your identity, not just feeling tired or freshness. Your identity goes through a change by just a cup of coffee. Then what kind of an identity you are carrying, which can get drowned in a cup of coffee? Understand. Physical, physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs you go through keeps you constantly inside the matrix. The uniqueness of Sadashivoham is not just getting you out of the physical, physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs, supporting you with the spiritual alchemy products so that the highest frequency is permanently bolted in your system. It stays in your system, I tell you. The spiritual alchemy products are going to be my unique contribution to Sanatana Hindu Dharma and to this world. I will establish the authenticity and legitimacy of the spiritual alchemy products through various powerful scientific researches and studies and the personal experiences. Soon you will see, we will create tons of material on establishing the authenticity of the spiritual alchemy products. That is going to be my unique contribution to Sanatana Hindu Dharma and to the planet Earth. Evolving literally enlightenment pills. Which you don't even need to consume it. You just need to have it around you. Pill will consume you. You don't need to consume it. It'll consume you. I also wanted to complete with all of you. I was telling yesterday we will be having some of the prana pratishtha and energy field preparation processes. Only after that we found out today is Amavasya. So actually today is the day I settled into the body. The day I settled into the body in 2000, that day was Amavasya, Deepavali together. But Amavasya was the reason why I settled into the body, not the Deepavali. So the Tithi was the reason. Tithi created the Vatavarana for me to settle into the body. Deepavali was the just coincidence. So we celebrate only on Amavasya day. Today evening only is Amavasya. Yesterday evening Amavasya did not start. So today we will be celebrating the settling day and the pranapratishthas for evolving enlightenment pill. Somebody asked me the question, when I look at the things that blocking me from coming to Sadashivoham, how do I know which ones are real and which ones are just my opinion? Everything is your opinion. Whatever is blocking is your opinion. Understand, whatever is making you come to Sadashivoham is real. Whatever is blocking you is your opinion. Even people who are dead are coming and attending the Sadashivoham. I told them, even the idea you are dead is an opinion, come and attend. Even if you think you are already dead and you can't attend Sadashivoham, it's an opinion, come and attend. It's not real. It is not real. So now I think I made it very clear. Everything which stops you from Sadashivoham is opinion. Everything which makes Sadashivoham for you is real. I am also sending the garba, which is ready now, prepared for all the people who cast themselves to Sadashivoham. All of them will be receiving it. Just keep it under your pillow and see the miracle. Nothing else. Just keep it under your pillow and sleep. Sleep your way to enlightenment. It's actually the initial preparatory level. A spiritual alchemy product, it is filled by literally God particle, Sadashiva in powder form. In Hindu tradition, we have a science to infuse the highest consciousness into matter. The highest consciousness is made to reverberate, vibrate in all its frequency in a matter and molecule. It is possible. These three things are unique to Sanatana Hindu Dharma. One, worshipping divine in the female form as mother. Unique to us. Anywhere, any other religion, tradition has it, it is from us. Declaration divine can be made to manifest in a matter like a deity or a statue or a product like this. This is unique to our Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Whichever is unique to us, that is what was being attacked. I tell you, if something is not attacked in Sanatana Hindu Dharma, a concept or an idea or a guru, don't go to him, he is useless. These concepts and sciences are unique to Sanatana Hindu Dharma, and I am making these truths available to you. Understand? I am making it very clear. I will make it happen for all of us. I will make Sadashivoham into reality for all of us. you ask how, the answer is, I can, that is why I am still alive. These spiritual alchemy products, you just need to keep it under your pillow and sleep. You will see the whole transformation of the quality of consciousness. You will go beyond waking, deep sleep, dream states into awakened Turiya. Your body and mind will be prepared to experience Sadashivoham here. So I am sending it now itself. Keep it under the pillow and sleep your way towards Sadashivoham. Sleep your way to Sadashivoham. Everything available in Sanatana Hindu Dharma to raise your consciousness and make you experience Sadashivatva, I am making everything available. Maybe all this, everything is made available for the first time after a long gap. Everything which stops you from Sadashivoham is opinion. Everything which leads you towards Sadashivoham is real. Anything which is under the Maya matrix cannot stop you. Declare your supremacy over the Maya matrix and wake up. Welcome to Sadashivoham 2016. So today, your Facebook status and the subject for Vakyartha Sadas is, I am declaring my supremacy over Maya matrix. I am in for Sadashivoham 2016. I am declaring my supremacy over Maya matrix. I am in for Sadashivoham 2016 is the subject for Vakyartha Sadas and the status for Facebook, essence of today's satsang, today's webinar. With this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.